Hi, everybody. Lori here. Thank you so much for joining me today. I've got another geometric experiment to share with you. Today, I'm working with squares. It's hip to be square. Did you know that? I'm using the basic square die set by Simons' Stamp, and I'm going to be using the three smallest squares. If you have a square die set, or if you don't, you can just cut some squares. Easy. You know, with your paper trimmer. And then I rummaged through my scrap drawer like a mad woman, trying to find three shades of any color family I could find. And you know, I always say this in my blog post. This is a great project to use up those scraps. But you know what? Let's keep it real. You and I both know, ain't nobody using up those scraps, honey bunny. Ain't nobody. My scraps just continue to grow at an alarming rate. And so I'll just leave that at that. So I'm adhering these squares together using a little Gina K tape runner. You could use whatever adhesive that tickles your fancy. Now, I don't know if there's a way to get these precisely centered and parallel. What I'm doing is the old eyeball technique. I'm eyeballing it. I'm winging it, just like I wing it through life. Although, you know what I've never done, speaking of wing it? I've never winged my eyeliner. Maybe I should try it. I don't know. I like it when I see it on others, but I just never had quite the guts. I'm a little conservative when it comes to makeup. My mom teases me. She's like, you like to wear makeup that looks like you have no makeup. I'm like, Mom, that's a thing. It's called the no makeup makeup look. That's what I do. So here's where she gets exciting. I'm trimming these squares in half, corner to corner, making the old beloved triangle. See that? Now, I'm really tempted to go one step further and cut them into fourths. If you wanna, you know how they say go hard or go home? Today I just went halvesies. I went halvesies, but I like halvesies. There's nothing wrong with that. These are looking mighty fine. And so I'm doing every one of these squares, cut them in half. It's really easy with this, you know, do you call this a guillotine or a guillotine? Or is it like tomato, tomato? I like to say guillotine because I like to get the L in there. But I'm afraid I might be saying it wrong. But you know what? I don't, you know, whatever. Okay, so I got all the squares cut in half. I cover a panel with tape runner. I'm going to adhere these all down, mixing and matching the colors. And of course, there are a million and one ways that you could arrange these colors, and I honestly don't think you could do anything to wreck it at this point. I think any arrangement would look Shazam fantastic. But I did have a plan. See how I do the aqua one way and then the aqua the other way? And I do the same on every row. So like for the pink, then I flip it. And it kind of makes this little funky shape right in the middle. I was going for that. I was feeling that. I don't know if you're picking up what I'm putting down, but I don't think there's a wrong way you could do it. Then popping up this panel on a nice white card base. This is a little larger of a card. It's 4.5 wide by 6.5 tall. Here's my previous card, which was a kickstart to this one. It got that geometric juices a-going again, and I don't think I'm finished yet, but for a sentiment, I needed something tall because it's a nice big tall card. I went with this big thanks. This is from Kathy Zielski's All the Thanks stamp set. I would have even liked to have something that was even taller, but I couldn't find it because I like a nice, clean look to my sentiment. I didn't want anything scripty. I wanted it clean and graphic, and you know you're going to find that with Kathy Zielski. So this is what I could find, and I embossed it in white onto black cardstock, popping that up right in the middle, just like so to finish it off. Not that you needed to, but I was feeling it, a few sparkling clear sequins here and there, and this card is finished. There she is. I'm loving it, but I do feel the urge to make another card and cut those squares into quarters this time, mixing up and matching the color. Like, you don't know. You never know until you know. You know? So I might have to try it. Are you game? Are you down? I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.